This ability to subtly influence people's choices without them being aware of it has been part of my skills and passions for years, and tonight we're going to take it to a new and unexplored level. But first, a potted history of subliminals. In 1957, this man, James Vickery, claimed that by flashing up in movie screens messages like "Hungry? Eat popcorn. Thirsty? Drink Coca-Cola," that he could make more people buy and... He claimed, Vickery, that he had tried this in cinemas in New Jersey and that sales went up by 57%. Vance Packard then fueled the fire by supporting Vickery's claims in his book, The Hidden Persuaders. This led to a public outcry and a United Nations report in which they concluded that subliminal indoctrination was, and I quote, a major threat to human rights. Now, because there is so much nonsense surrounding the idea of subliminals, researchers now tend to talk in terms of PWA, which is perception without awareness, instead of subliminals. And the difference is that subliminals are invisible, whereas PWA you just don't pay attention to. Like, for example, if somebody whistles a tune and you're not really aware of them doing it, but later on you start whistling that tune yourself and you don't know why, that would be perception without awareness. And this is another example of it. I invited two members of MBA, an advertising agency, to a secret location to propose an unusual task. Those who work in advertising are masters of persuasion. They subtly weave their images and slogans into our daily lives, knowing that we will register so much unconsciously. And then we walk into a supermarket and feel a sense of familiarity with a product we think we've never heard of. Millions of pounds a year are spent on it. It's brilliantly calculated, and we all fall for it. So I thought I'd turn the tables on the advertising experts. Thank you for joining us, gentlemen. Tony, yes?
Yes, that's right.
And Martin?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Darren. Let me get down to explaining exactly what I want you to do. Imagine that I'm opening a chain of stores selling a product, something I have a particular interest in. Your task is to come up with a poster advertising that store. And that poster must include the company name, whatever you decide that may be. It must include a strap line, some sort of slogan, and some kind of logo as well, some kind of visual image.
Sure.
Now, the idea is you've only got half an hour to do this, so you've got to really work with your first instinct. So at the moment, you've got no idea what you're going to do, correct?
Yeah.
Excellent. I'm also going to give you this. I've had a few design ideas of my own.
Okay.
I want to leave this untouched. We'll come back to that later. All right? Are there any questions?
What's the product?
What's the product? Very good question. Passion of mine since I was a toddler. It's a chain of taxidermy stores.
Ooh.
Let me pop the pussycat on the envelope so it remains untouched. You have half an hour, gentlemen. Good luck.
Great, thanks.
Right, let's go for it.
Get stuffed is a start. Right.
Animal Hospital.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
ones who didn't make it. Oh, no, that's probably just stupid.
To do with wings.
Our creature's great and small. Quality that says, like, nice, positive type of animals. Animal heaven. Where animals go.
Animal heaven, that's good.
Graveyard.
Animal heaven's good.
Animal heaven.
Where the best animals go to.
Loads of clouds with animals on them.
Yeah,
gates,
harps,
pearly gates, bear playing a harp.
Yeah. Only the best
Zoo.
Get in. Only the best get into air.
Yeah. Where dead animals go animals. To live. Where the best.
The best place for dead animals. It's simple.
Time up, gentlemen. Okay. I can't wait to see what you've done. Come and show me.
Okay.
And Tony, before we do this, can you take the envelope I gave you earlier?
Okay.
And can you please vouch for us here that no one's been anywhere near it? He's been under a dead cat. No one's touched it.
That's right.
That's the truth.
That's the truth.
Keep hold of it. Come around here. Now, before we have a look at it, just tell me, what was it like?
We started off thinking about the name. I thought that was we thought that was probably the best thing to do.
The starting point.
Sure.
And then take it from there, really. We banged out a lot of ones that were probably completely stupid, and then got down to the ones that were slightly stupid,
mm-hmm.
and then we kind of that went back and forth for a bit, and then kind of got something we liked and developed it.
You can have a look.
Sure.
Sure.
Is this it?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. It's a bear with a lyre.
So it's animal heaven, the best place for dead animals.
And it's obviously, you'd see that it was stuffed.
How did you come up with the name animal heaven?
We had the idea of the pearly gates of heaven. Being a zoo gate.
Zoo gates as the gates of heaven, that's interesting.
I.e. sort of all the animals that are dead are in a dead zoo, if you like, in heaven. And then we just kind of thought, well, it's kind of nice, but it's a bit twee. We wanted to make it a bit funkier. And then we thought a hard playing bear, just answered the brief.
That's fantastic. I do want to show you my own ideas from beforehand.
Okay.
I don't want to touch. Would you open them for me?
Sure.
And the winner is...
I think you'll find this interesting.
Okay.
Get rid of the envelope.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay. All right. Not a million miles away. Let me put this up there. Hang on to that. It's a heart playing bear.
Yeah.
God.
You've gone for these angel wings here. Were you thinking of angel wings or bird wings?
Yeah. They were kind of a combination.
You do them a lot better than me. This was the same thing. I was thinking angel wings there. You've got animal heaven. I got creature heaven.
Yeah.
So where the best?
You're a bit off there then.
A bit off there. Where the best dead animals go. Did you put blessed place for dead animals?
Wow.
Very similar. I had the idea of a zoo gate on there.
It was hard to leave out.
We didn't want to overload it.
It was hard to leave out, but sure. It was just a bit too much.
Can I see your other, the other one you were talking about?
Yeah, it's just before there.
Is it very different?
Well, it's just the gate.
Yeah.
Oh, gentlemen, please.
Yeah, I'm drawing quite similar.
Look at that. This was the image I was thinking. I've done it there in the background, because this to me was the more striking image, and interestingly you abandoned this for this one. This was obviously clear in your mind.
The first bear I drew looks exactly like that one, actually.
It did, yeah.
The first bear you drew?
Yeah, I'll show you on the notes.
Show me? Like that, show me, what have you got?
Well, this is scary, really. But,
look at that.
Yeah.
Look at that. You've got the cloud, you've got the blue. If you knew the amount of effort we've gone into making this work, you'd be absolutely flabbergasted. But for now, it's comforting to know that you're just as susceptible to subliminal persuasion as the rest of us. Thank you very much for helping us out. Tony,
thank you.
Martin.
Pleasure.
Take care. Thanks very much indeed.
Bye-bye. I think I'm quite cynical. When I saw the bear and I saw a cloud, first of all, from behind the paper, I thought, hang on, he's close here. And then when we saw the rest of it, couldn't believe it.
I immediately thought, oh, I'm gutted. I could see that it was folded, and I just saw the bear's foot hanging over the cloud with the harp.
Yeah.
And I just thought, oh, I can't believe it.
Yeah.
You know, it was gutted.
How embarrassing.
But now I think, oh, fantastic, you know, I'm over the moon.
I mean, obviously we're pleased for him, you know.
Yeah.
So,
he's
as long as, if he comes out of this looking good, then that's always the main thing.
To see how we did it, watch their taxi journey again.
Put a spell on you. Cause you're mine. Do, 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 do. You better stop the things you do.
American shopping malls, modern cathedrals to spending money. They're designed to disorient us and make us stay longer than we need to. Every brick is there to manipulate us to buy. It's the perfect place to find a large number of compliant people to affect.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Palisades Mall. We hope that your shopping experience is an uplifting one, and I'd like to bring to your pay attention some very special offers today.
What you're hearing in the background is a public address announcement I've pre-recorded and played throughout the shopping centre. After about half an hour of absorbing it, they should be ready for their final message. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Palisades Mall. We hope that your shopping experience is an uplifting one, and I'd like to bring to your pay attention some very special offers today. Details of our special offers can be found handily by the elevators, so why not come right arm up and see for yourselves. Our special offers will only be available for a short period of time, so all those customers wishing to reach up and grab this exciting opportunity should do so now.
Everybody raised their hand. It was just weird because I'm walking around and he's like, now, and everybody raised their hand.
Someone gave me a phone call and I was calling. I was talking to my friend. He was talking to me. And the guy was like, do it now. I put my hand up. And then when I turned around, everybody was doing the same gesture and I was like, what was going on?
You're were walking around, and we heard an announcement, and all of a sudden we all raised our hands.
It was weird.
We turned around, and everyone had their hands up in the air. Just really weird.
We had our hands up, too.
Really odd.